screw these coupling nuts on. Thread them on. I'll tighten the wrench in a minute. Probably two of them. And then if I take the Sharpie marker on the end of it here, let's color it. This is chamfered on the side so it fits in there nice and tight. Where to drill my hole. Goes here, that nut will actually countersink into that hole. Don't drop it on my head. My impact down there, I think. Good? Thing like a hold it in place, and then the bullet is a blank that goes in the little hole, and then you push it up.
Yep. That's not squeezing it.
Twist it and squeeze it.
Yeah, there you go. Safety glasses.
I'm up here on the scaffolding putting together the railing that goes around it. I'm pretty comfortable on the first level of the scaffolding. The second one's gonna be a whole nother story. Currently up, my head height is probably about 14, 15 feet. So I'm making a pass-through trap door on this. So when I'm on the second level or higher, I can climb up the ladder on the inside and get in without having to climb up on the outside and then go into it that way. So if I don't have it all the way up. So just making a little trap door. Got to remove this one little beam that's on here. And I've cut the hole through the wood already and make a little hinge door. Okay, so I got the hole cut out and I took the brace and I cut it out and I'm moving it over and then we're gonna weld that back in place. It was over here originally. So that gives room to come up through there and support for the floor. A little pass-through area there came out nice. Makes it much easier and safer to climb up on the inside versus climbing up on the outside of the scaffolding. John's super tall. How tall are you, John?
6'2.5".
6'2.5", and he couldn't quite reach, so we needed to elevate the scaffolding about 3 more inches. It worked. Those are 2x12s. Window, 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 door, window, 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 wall. So, whole row of windows. And they will be up above as well. People in glass houses, well, who knows? Probably should have curtains. Well, there's a word I never heard.
Don't you do it.
Come on, let's see you drive that big old truck. You gotta push the clutch in and...
What?
I was gonna say, you gotta push the clutch all the way down, and I think you have to hit the brake on too.
Oh my god. My knees feel like I have to get the clutch all the way down. My knees are hitting.
Forward, forward. None of this is done framing yet, so lots of blocking and all kinds of stuff to get done still on what is here, and then obviously we got to continue to build up. That was the door from the shop that I just came through into the apartment. This will all be kind of living room area over here with all the windows, door, windows. This will be the kitchen. Just getting that back wall framed up right now back there. And the ceiling for the kitchen and the bathroom will be the bedroom loft that will be up there. There'll be a staircase that goes from here up to there against the wall. And then this is the doorway entrance into the bathroom. Have a vanity, toilet. There'll be a couple little walls that come out just a little bit, and then there'll be glass coming from the walls, and that'll be a shower area in the middle. On the other side of the shower will be a bathtub. So it'll be a double shower, shower on this side and shower on that side. All tile everywhere. There'll be a little shelf back there behind the bathtub, and then the wall will angle upwards. It'll be 2x4 wall back there. But it's starting to look like something. The view from the bedroom loft. Beautiful. So on the outside here, that will cantilever out about 2 feet there for the bedroom loft part, but that's just an exterior kind of architectural design there that'll be boxed out and just to break up the lines a little bit, and then basically just windows all the way up here on the end as well. So but just that little bit of cantilever is kind of neat. It's still within the roof line though of the hut. Headers are larger over there because that's all load-bearing stuff, and then everything here is non-load-bearing. There's no roof load transferred, anything. It's just the end wall that's going to be there. So and then this will be the shop, and it's still over 50 feet long, so plenty of room to get buses in and out. Feet wide. Thanks for watching.